In golf, you have so many different components that you have to put together to make the ball go in the direction that you want. It's similar to research in the sense that you have all these variables that you have to be able to pull together to make the reaction work.
If you really do science, you can't do it on your own. You've got to collaborate. You've got to work with others at all kinds of different levels. My area of specialty is organic chemistry, and most students take that at the sophomore level, their second year at Grinnell. So it's a two-semester course where we teach them the most basic fundamental topics in that course and then work towards more complex problems. Even when I lecture in my classroom, it's a very interactive lecture. The students are leading the lecture. If we get to areas where I can definitely tell they're just not quite getting it, we'll break into small groups and do different small group activities.
Professors are so open and willing to help their students. I went and I started to talk to my professor second semester, and it made the world of a difference.
She golfs, so we talk a little bit about golf. I try to know my students more than just that they're in my class, so they feel comfortable, that if they're struggling, they can come to me.
They want you to be successful and they want you to get results.
We've developed the labs in organic chemistry, general chemistry, and other chemistry classes to prepare them so once they start doing research, it's not a huge step. We're not just teaching them content, we're teaching them how to learn material, how to deliver that material. So when they get into that research experience, they're ready to go. They already know how to do the science. Of our chemistry majors, 60 to 70% are off to graduate programs, and not just any graduate programs, the top graduate programs in the country. Harvard, MIT, Stanford, Berkeley, Cal Irvine, all the top schools. And students in my research group, I treat them like they were my colleague or a graduate student. They're coming up with ideas, planning experiments, they're doing the research.
So what did you do differently this time to get that to really go forward?
Let it sit for a while with the base and ran it at a higher temperature in the microwave.
Moving forward, are you going to look at some other aldehydes?
Yeah, I'll look at the methoxy.
Great. All right, keep it up.
I did math this summer, and it's a mentored advanced project.
Stephanie worked on a project that was trying to come up with a new way of making a molecule known as a cinnamate.
Research this summer was not always success.
Things were not going well. And a lot of times when things don't go well, students get really discouraged. I remember telling Stephanie, you know what to do, just attack it.
If it doesn't work, doesn't mean you have no results. It means you have the result if it doesn't work.
The whole point of these maps is not that the project ultimately is going to be successful, because in science you fail 90% of the time, probably even more than that. It's 100% about process.
Is a big part of both golf and research. When you get something right in lab, it's just like making a birdie or getting a one-putt. You're just like, oh my gosh. It's just this rush of happiness that you have finally succeeded.